Building the rear differential on the X-Ray X4 is very similar to building the diff on the T4. But either way, I'm gonna show you how I do it in a very detailed way. And you're probably gonna recognize a lot of the parts in the diff, even though the diff case itself has changed. The internal parts are still the same as on the T4. You gotta separate all the parts here, make sure that you don't lose any of the small parts of the diff. Got 4 shims here, 2 big shims, the outdrives. The outdrives of the diff, they come in an aluminium material. We also offer these in steel for more durability, and especially if you want to use the ECS ball bearing drive shafts, you'll need to use the specific ball bearing outdrives for the diff. But for this build, I'm going to use the kit aluminium outdrives. First thing I'll do is I remove the plastic gears from the mold tree. Take these out of here. What you then need to do is you need to make sure that all the gears are perfectly round, that there's no excess plastic left from the mold. So you can cut these pieces away with a hoodie hobby knife. It's the best tool to use for this purpose. So cut all these things away. Make sure that they are looking nice and smooth. To be able to have the smoothest possible diff action. Okay, now I'm happy with the gears. They all look perfect. So what we're gonna do then is we're gonna install the O-rings in the diff cases. So before installing the O-rings in a diff case, I'm going to soak them in silicone oil. In this case, I'm using Hoodie 7000 silicone oil. Make sure you get some oil onto these O-rings before you install them in the diff cases. Then put them in here, one in the top, one in the bottom diff case, and then we can install these large diameter shims on top of the O-rings. When that's done, we're gonna proceed to install the outdrives in the diff. So here, it's a nice idea to drop a little bit of oil onto the outdrive to make sure that there's no excess friction going on here. So you put some oil on the outdrives before installing them into the case. Then I'm gonna use a Hoodie long nose pliers to install these pins into the outdrives. So we start with the top here. It's very easy, just put it in place. Push it in with your pliers. And we can already put the gear in place here. And turn the outdrive to make sure that it's spinning freely. Everything feels great. And we move on to the next outdrive. Push it into the housing of the diff. When it comes to installing the pin in the lower part of the diff, you have to look for the part of the diff case where it's marked here with 2 lines. that's the part of the diff where you need to install the little pin, because it's got a bigger opening in that side of the diff case. So once again, we grab the pin with the pliers and we put it in there in the spot where I just showed you. Push the pin in, put the gear in. And again, we need to make sure that it's moving freely, and that feels great. Put this aside for now. And we're gonna start to assemble the small gears. We put these four gears on this plastic part. All four of them, and don't forget these small diameter steel shims that goes on the outside of the gears. So, that's all done. We can install these gears into the diff. I do this before pouring oil into the diff. So put all the gears inside before you put any oil in there. Then we have the paper gasket, which is sealing the diff in the top part. It's a little fragile, so make sure you don't break it. Put this in here. And finally, we are going to put some oil in the diff. The most precise way to put the right amount of oil is to use a digital scale, which I'm going to use this one from Hoodie. It's great for this purpose. So what we do is we put the assembled diff onto the scale and we check what it weighs. It weighs in at around 9.5 grams. And I usually put 1.5 grams of oil into the diff. So this means that the number we're looking for here is 11 grams when it's ready. So we're gonna use Hoodie oil. This is a 7000 oil. About the oil viscosity, you can fine tune the hardness of the diff with different oil viscosities, and Hoodie offer oils as soft as 1000 up to even 20000. The range which we usually try to use for the X4 is between 3000 up to 15000, and the higher you go, the more forward drive you'll have, but the less side bite, so the less forgiving the car will be for low grip conditions. So a good starting point for lower grip is between 5, 6, and 7000, and for higher grip you can go up to 8, 9, 10, even 12 or 15000, depending on the grip levels that you're racing on. And in this case we're going to install 7000, which is a good starting point. And we put the diff on the scale as I explained earlier, and we put the oil inside. It's important here that you put oil also on the outside of the gears, so not only in the center part. Carefully look for the weight. So now it's 10.7 almost, but we want to get to 11, so now it's 10.9. I'm just gonna add a bit more oil. And that's 10.99, so that's perfect. That's 11 grams weight, which means we have 1.5 grams of oil in the diff. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the Hoodie airbag to remove the excess air bubbles from the diff. This airbag comes with an adapter for the differential. So you just put it in here and you can install your differential into the airbag. Close this and we're going to connect our airbag to a battery. You can also connect this to a power supply. It gives it even more power and even more efficiency, but it still works great on a 2-cell LiPo battery. So connect the airbag like that, make sure that it's sealed in the top. And we start the airbag with the button at the back. We hold the button for between 10 to 30 seconds, depending on the amount of air bubbles that you see inside. And if you look closely, you can see that the air bubbles are escaping from the oil. And removing these air bubbles will give you a more smooth diff action and a more consistent performance. Okay, so we wait for a minute to let the air bubbles escape. Yeah. After 1 minute of waiting, the air bubbles are now all gone and we can release the pressure from the airbag. So we open the top seal. You can hear the air disappearing. Take this out. Put this aside. The last step to close the diff is to install the included O-ring. This O-ring is the final seal of the diff, which we put carefully on top of the diff case here. If you are rebuilding your diff, always make sure that the O-ring hasn't swollen up too much, so that it's not gotten too big, because it can cause leaking issues with the diff. So always make sure that the O-ring is in good condition and not too big. And I recommend changing it whenever it's gotten too big. So we then put the top case on. Look for the little notch here in the diff case so that it lines up with the two lines on the bottom of the diff case. That's the direction that it has to go. Put the top case on. If you've done this correctly, there should be no excess oil coming out of the diff when you put the lid on. And we then start to screw these 2.5 millimeter screws in. You need to thread these screws in step by step, so don't do one side at once, for example. Do them all together, but slowly tighten all of them until you have the lid completely closed. Make sure that you don't over tighten these screws because you can damage the diff case. Just tighten them down so that the screw is sitting snugly into the plastic. And that's differential, perfectly built, feels great, feels very smooth, and we can move on to the next step.